Absolut. Thank you, Kuba, for the opportunity to speak here and the great conference so far. You know, the aftershow party yesterday. And I heard about Damien. Damien Schimmack was there. It was not me. It's another one. So I'm Damien Schimmack, work science Magento Beta. And my specialties are, I'm expert in import-export and the search. Yeah, I'm 27 years old and work now on a company called FlagBit GmbH and Co. KG, and it's located in Germany. So the topic are better searches, search engines. The idea was to compare Solr, Apache Solr, Elasticsearch, and Sphinx. But I see the notebook is there, the presentation, so I can give you a demo quite there. So if you like to see some demos, so come after the presentation and we can look your search results. Or even if you have here your databases, so we can try it. Just today in the morning, Benchmarks write something really good. Just reified that the architecture of Magento Catalog Search is a hot mess. And yeah, he's right. It's not easy. You have, I give you some points to write your own search engine. But as a community has some project, Elasticsearch, Solr, and other stuff, maybe you can work with this together or code yourself. Okay, this is some hypes at the moment, the searches. First beginning with Apache Solr. It's quite hype at the moment on Elasticsearch. Lucene, it's really old project, common and very old. And Sphinx also, it's quite enough time alive. So why you code your own search engine? It's quite easy because a customer search something like you have some Magento sample data and you search for Intel, and who knows the sample data? Everyone, right? Normally. So when you type with some Magento 1.7 Intel in the search query and you get the first results was a bundle product, the computer. The third and fourth result is the Intel processor. And the customer needs this on the first position, not in the middle of something, because Intel is relevance. So relevant, and this is why you need to care of the search in Magento, because I know because there's a bad results. Okay, the problem is. Search engines and everything is really complicated. And you have maybe 100 products or 3 million products, and you have a project manager, you have the customer, and the customer says, okay, when I type, I know, Intel, so it's need to go on the front, but when you type AMD or whatever, you need to redefine the combination, and the customer needs some efforts to get maybe his own company on the front results, then comes the other companies to get more money for the company. All the stuff is really, really complicated with MySQL, and the search engines can't help you with this problem. Okay, this is a Magento search engine. First, the indexer is really slow when you have many products. And second, the results are not good. This is any other engines. Most of them are really, really fast, has less memory use. And the one thing is when you have your own search engine, use Apache Solr or Elasticsearch, whatever, you need a server. Apache Solr is based on Java, so you need a server with Java installed, and you have a daemon that's running. So normal web hosting companies didn't get you the opportunity to use Apache Solr. Okay, And one thing that I love and I discuss and I hate is layer navigation. I mentioned the MySQL search is really slow. It's really slow in the results, and Magento is really slow because the layer navigation, you know this on the right side, he makes some big SQL queries. And if you have many products and many filters, so the site needs 5 seconds to load. And it's, yeah, it's a mess. So what we make, or I make in Apache Solar, to the left side, is a German thing, sorry for this, by category, price, and yeah, manufacturer. For one customer is, you can, and Elasticsearch also thinks everything is possible, to make the filters came from Solar, because when you put a search to Solar, he gives you back the filter navigation if you need it. So Solar counts the numbers, Solar counts the manufacturers, and yeah, makes the search better. So we code, I show you some codes later, we code a solution to don't hit Magento on the results. So make own variant objects, own products, own collection, to doesn't use MySQL. And one good thing, or many customer wishes, is to use normal text fields, not select, multi-select fields to filter, also text fields. And you can also use normal text fields to use as a filter. And another one is to multi-select things. So you search for something and you put it on two categories. No, normally when you filter one thing, so the filter disappears. So when the category, and that's all. One category you check out, you cannot check on the second category. So yeah, and here in this one, I can choose two categories or five or whatever, and you have the results. Yeah, the customers experience a little bit better. So maybe the product is a category computer and tablet PCs or whatever. So you can click it, and the results comes back. Okay. So why? So it's why Solar? It's performance. It's fast. It's open source. You can use it. You also have a replication. If you have a heavy site with many searches, so you can have more. That's one server, like MySQL, one master, many slaves, everything is possible. And the main thing is layer navigation comes from Solar. Otherwise, like Google, do you mean auto-completion? Everything comes from Solar, also from Elasticsearch. So it's a big effort. Okay, some slides about Solar. Okay, sorry, it's German. I don't. Okay, okay. Solar is based on the Lucene index. Lucene has schemata structure, and it's a one file, and it's normally is a little bit static. This index. You can put documents inside. One document is in Magento relation. One product. And yeah, the product has many attributes. So this is the normal Lucene stuff. The good thing is the Solar APIs, so you can get via HTTP the results. And this is a great stuff. You have the opportunity to use some clients, PHP clients, Ruby clients, whatever you have, and get the answer in JSON, XML, or in a serialized PHP object when you wish. It's crazy and it's dangerous, but you can have it, right? And everyone knows here HTTP and JSON. We love JSON at the moment. And so it's really easy to read and code. Okay, it's totally easy. When you like to test Solar, it's really, you download the package, it's quite big, 100 MB megabyte. Then you when you have installed Java, start the jar file, push data into index. Solar has example packages, so you can put some data inside. And then you go to the HTTP server on the port 8983 in Solar. And you have, in the new version 4.0, you have a really nice, shiny admin interface. Before this version was, it was not so shiny. But you can search and you can debug your stuff. So when this customer says, why this product doesn't came up in the results? So you put the search query into the admin interface and you can debug why they didn't find the product, why, maybe it's the product is not in the index. Why? And you can debug. So it's really great, really easy for us to debug the stuff. So one problem is, or the challenge is, import the data, build the layer navigation. Some customers need also a full text, boost some attributes, tags, because Magento, you can give the products tags, but Magento doesn't search the tags. So it's, it's a little bit stupid, but And how to work with product updates. Okay, first I search a picture of the normal tables. How many knows the normal MySQL databases? You know this. Okay, the three tables are normally the MySQL search in Magento. You have the, catalog search full text, there's the full text inside, right? You have the query table and the result table. The full text table contains the product and, you know, full text is separated by the stuff, and you have the product ID, the store ID, and everything is good. But it's only the full text or like. This is I think the result. I have no. I don't copy the whole table because it's too big. So only the structure. You have the query text, the customer type in, number of results, probability, display is active, blah, 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 blah. Many things you don't really need it. But really interesting is the number of results, because Magento generates from this. If I have found a query in the result, results table, it matches, so he gets the numbers from there, from this table. He doesn't generate a search every time. And make a search, he gets the numbers from this table. You have the choice search tab. This is Magento's choice that give you. The search tab is like full text or both. So it's really quite easy to understand. Okay, some people told me it's bad to make screenshots and copy, but can everyone read this? Okay. So I think this is the most important thing, how to understand how the normal full text search work in Magento. Normally it's quite, it's process running. When out gets a word, gets a query, and then in the center you see splitting words, decide is this a like search, is this a full text search or both, and put this together in bind and like. In like conditions, get the fields, get the select, and very interesting is when you make the select, Magento make only one thing. He search the products, get the product IDs, save the product IDs in the third table, I doesn't mention here, only the product IDs, and make then a collection and filter on this product IDs and load it. So you search on. You have a heavy search on the MySQL database, get only the product IDs back, and then you load the collection with the product IDs. So this is how this works. Okay, and this is like the last mention here. So with the where and whatever, and at the end save the query and it's done. Now I think about 1 year about my solution, how to get a good point, entry point to make a good search engine. And I mentioned, I think, science 1.4, Magento make this cool function. It was the first in the resource model. Now it's in a helper, but it does the same. You can, the Magento looks up in the database or config files to get the store config. And if catalog search engine is set or is there a value, he make, load a class name, check something, model and test, whatever. So you need to emulate this in your search engine. And when everything is good, fine, he loads your engine, not the MySQL engine, yours engine. So this is the first step, and I found this after I rewrite 5 classes, and then I delete the 5 rewrites because it's quite easy to set the database value, right? Good. This was only the search. So the first step was also for me to make the engine work. So I do like the same like Magento. So I get this query to Solar, get only the product IDs back, and load the product IDs. But in the Enterprise Edition, Solar is also integrated, and I think it's a cool feature, but the code is a mess. You can load the data, so the items, the product items, also from Solar. You make collections from Solar, from the Solar results. So the catalog, when you go over the catalog, Solar can gives you the data, not Magento, not MySQL. So everything came from Solar. And this is quite fast. It's like because the people like now Varnish to get performance and whatever. But when you, in some point, Magento is hit because Varnish doesn't cache the stuff. So Magento is also slow, slower, it depends on. And with this, you get your data and your front end really, really fast. And I think this is a challenge to build up a complete to build the enterprise extension, right? For and not, don't copy this, so only use it. So I hopefully right okay. I know my cursor. So hopefully this is only I only use this search at this moment. So I have not so many slides, so I talk a little bit, like free. The import data is really interesting because you think, okay, how I get to the data in my search engine. And when you mention this tag, you can use your engine, and this one function that get from Magento the data in an array, and you need only translate to your structure, Solar structure, Elasticsearch structure, one time. The good thing is, you use a Magento search indexer. You don't need your own indexer because you get in there. The product save in backend or frontend or whatever in PHP also use this function. So you don't need get observer done, whatever. It's only this one line. This fucking one line is a code and everything work. So you need only one translation. So this was the easiest part. Now the layer navigation. How many knows how the layer navigation works? 1, 2. Oh, okay, and not so many. Okay, normally you make really 2 queries. First, yes, I mentioned the product IDs, and the second query only for the filter, layer filter. So, and the MySQL SQL is really complex on this. At this point, and you need to get the results back, build your own collection on the right thing, because on the right point, and build only one collection, normal collection. You make new var object, or your get model and get new product model. Put your items because you can translate. I mentioned it's JSON. So I manage this like I get the results back with right keys. So I get the JSON result back. And I make only set data. JSON to array, from array, set data, and have my object. It's nothing, it's really fast. So yeah, the main problem was to use the filter, because Magento use sorting and the get URLs parameter to match up to your query to Solr. So this is the hard work when you click it to get your results in the right, decisions. But also it's really easy. You have the choice in Solr. Boost attributes and things you can boost, because maybe it's a product name, it's higher, like the description. So it can boost things. It's also very important if you have a large database, so the customer gets the right results, the better results, right? So, and the good stuff is you can pre-compile the boost fields in Solr. So one time when you index it as data, so they're already boosted in the index. But you can choose this for performance, because it's, I think the normal search needs 100 milliseconds. And if you boost in real time, so I think it's 150 milliseconds. So it's a little bit longer Solr in this time, but also it's fast. You can boost on time to test with your customer how the boosting works and how you can redefine the things. And also you can put some stuff inside, like tags in search. The tags, CMS sites, static blocks, all your content. Why, when somebody search about guarantee stuff? So you have pages, you have many texts, or maybe you have a WordPress or another CMS, I don't know, it's Drupal, Joomla, whatever. You can have one index to search in other sites. So you can, maybe you have a really old blog, whatever, with really great content for your site. So, and many customers say, we worked 2 years now to get content for Google, right? SEO, blah, blah, blah. And now you search and I need the content in my search. So you also can have not only products in your search results, any type when you want. Because you can set the object, the URL key is the same, you can get your normal, so you can link to other domains, so you can combine the stuff with your own search engine. I think it's a great thing you can make with search engines. Okay, now normally I was done because your demo time. So if you need a demo or would see like this work, it's really quite easy. I can get you some code stuff here after the session or the whole day, and tomorrow I'm here. If you have questions, ask me. I know the search thing is really complicated. Not the Magento stuff, but the search of the work. So it's not a problem to get questions in Polish, so I can understand Polish, so I can answer you in English if you have a question. If you have a question. Anyone? Yes?
What's the difference between your solution and the enterprise solution?
Can you show you the code?
Okay.
It's clean, really clean. My solution. Sorry, and
in terms of functionality, what's the difference? What's the difference in terms of functionality between the enterprise Solr search and your
What's your features?
Layered navigation, doing catalog pages through Solr, and search of products.
Right, so yeah. Normally you have no effort, because I make the same, right? Because it's the same system. You have, in my X engine, you can put other product content types inside, mm-hmm. but the code, you code, I think last version I see for an enterprise, you work with the schemata, right? Schema in Solr, you need to get this, your fields, you're mapping your fields.
Yeah, schema. Okay.
I think it's in your solution static.
I'm not sure,
it's static, and I make a solution so the customer can go to the back end, click like Magento-like, get this in the search, and it's in the search. You rerun the indexer, and everything is there. He doesn't need to care about Solar. Only one time to set up. That's all. Like, and the same, like this is now a filter, this attribute. Also, no problem. It's, yeah, index the stuff, and it's work.
Is it an extension that you can download or purchase from Magenta Connect?
This extension is not free.
Yeah, that's okay, but...
Yeah, it's pay.
Okay.
But Elasticsearch, Sphinx make quite the same. It's only another search engine.
Damien, I have a small question. Yeah, thank you. So I have a small question about how is the index built? Is it built by using a Lucene database adapter, or you are doing it via API?
Not Lucene. I import the data about HTTP requests in JSON. So no Lucene, because Lucene is a same framework. It's slow.
Yeah, but I mean a different thing. I mean that you're using the JSON API, but I mean connection of Lucene directly to your database.
You can have, but I don't use this function. You mean to migrate the data?
Yeah, because if you have a very large web shop, it becomes a problem to generate this search index.
Right. So some customers generate from the some systems intern. With these numbers direct to Solar. So you don't need to index from Magento to Solar. You can put in other ways Solar index. But you need the data, so yeah. When you have many data, it's right, it's faster.
And you mentioned that you have different way of prioritizing attributes for Solar. So can you explain a bit more about this?
Code. We can.
In words.
Yeah, I show you the code. And
okay, thank you.
It's I worked 2 years now on this project and thinking about, and to find a good way, and this is a good way. I think this is a good way. Any questions? Oh, it's a trick question. So the question was what I think about Sphinx or Elasticsearch. It depends on what you need for features. With your data, because I know in Solar you can get for every language own analyzers, stemming words, plural, singularity. So when I search for a car, I get also cars, or I search for cars, I get also car. A fuzzy search, like when I have a typo, but this also can Sphinx. So it's normally it's your decision on what your feature you need really, and what's your hosting company or what your server is, how you have expertise. So when you think, I have no problem with other search engines, in different ways he makes the same. The search is better in one way. So it works. I have a demo also from Ahead Works, so it's installed on my notebook, so you can compare when you will with the sample data. So I can show you. It's quite the same. Any questions? No? Well, thank you.